Hood Rich Mob.
It's your girl, Azpen Winters, representing that 303.
Yo, it's your boy, Duce, McGuire, Boss Up Entertainment and Dream Big Media.
What it do? It's your boy, Young P, signing in. You niggas know how I'm rocking Boss Up every day.
You gotta tune in with me.
Sick Mackie over there at
Headklap Radio, fucking with my nigga Doja, man.
Man, the whole squad gonna be there.
Talking about all the latest moves that we making, all the latest albums and mixtapes, you feel me?
Alpha Male Volume 2 drops June 14th.
I ain't even gotta explain much more.
Headklap Radio.
Headklap Radio, man. Y'all tune in.
Boss up everything.
Boss up everything.
What's up, bro? It's your boy, Devin's Doja Man, and this is Headklapp Radio, the hottest local radio shows in Denver, Colorado, featuring some of the dopest rap and rock artists in the city as well. But not only that, you know, we spread our wings, we got models, we got promoters, we got everything you need. Hey, look, y'all, we got a dope show in store, you know what I'm saying? We got nothing but Boss Up Entertainment.
Let's go!
Man, I got a true love and a true place in my heart for Montbello, you know what I'm saying? Because when things was getting crazy in the hood and I had to get out of there, that's where I went, you know what I'm saying? That was the place where I found music in the sense, you know what I'm saying? The culture enamored from the late great Cat, R.I.P., Interstate Ike, Young Doe. Cats have been putting in work in the city of Denver for a real long time, you know what I'm saying? Came straight out of Montbello. And today, or should I say tonight, we got some of the dopest Montbello artists that Denver has to offer right here in the building. So without further ado, it's Denver Doja Man, Headklapp Radio.
We in the building, baby! Ah! Boss up everything we in here. Let go! Kofax Cat. Y'all know what we doing, man. We starting this live feed, man. We up here at Headklapp Radio with Doja Man. You know what I mean? Sick Mackie. They got us in the building. I got the squad with me. Ah! Denver, Colorado, stand up. You know what I mean? You're listening to that Kofax Cap right now. Let's go. Did I say mob yet? If not, mob. Y'all people, man, what's happening?
It's your girl, Azpen, better known as the coldest winner ever. You know, repping that Boss Up Entertainment, can't get no better than that. So let's do it. We're up here with all the bros.
Yes, Lord. What up, bro?
Well, represent Boss Up Entertainment. You know how we do, baby.
Yes, sir. We got the loved ones in the back. Y'all see them?
Got the
turned all the way up, man. All right, y'all know that guy.
Hey, man, it's Young Peezz. Boss Up everything, man. Go grab that new mixtape, June 14th, Alpha Male Volume 2, man. Y'all know how we rocking. Shout out to the best engineer in the motherfucking world,
though. Y'all know it. We got Megan Boo in the building, man, / CFO of Boss Up Entertainment.
What's up, y'all?
Hood Rich, Boss Up Entertainment, man, CEO of that thing, you know what I'm saying? But more than the title, I'm a boss first and a man first and an artist second. You feel me? This is all family love, and we out here doing it real big right now with Headklapp Radio, Sick Mackie, and who's that guy? What's that guy's name?
Doja Mane
in the building. Let's get it.
All right, moving on, you know what I'm saying? We're going to keep it in clockwise status. So who you got next from Duce McGuire, man? Let the fans know who you is and what you're all about.
What it do? It's your boy Duce McGuire, representing Boss Up Entertainment. We're the villain, you know what I'm saying? Y'all want y'all tracks hooked up? Connect with me, man.
Dream Big Studio.
Dream Big Media, man. We got two studios in effect right now. We got A and B, and we getting it going and cracking like concrete. And that's what we do. Ma!
Yeah. Moving forward, man. Who we got sitting next to you? Deuce?
You got Azpen. It's your girl, Azpen. Azpen Winters, you know, coming out of the 303. Upcoming artists, you know, got my rapping coming along and everything. And definitely out here doing my modeling. So, you know, IG, Azpen Winters. And definitely look me up because I'm who you want.
Yes. Hey! Let's go!
But not least, man,
here
we go over here.
You got the Alpha Male in this mug, you know what I'm saying? Boss Up everything, man. You can follow me on Snapchat at Mr. Mafioso. You can follow me on Facebook at Yannick or Yon Peezz. Just hit me up. Go grab that new Alpha Male, man. It dropped June 14th. Holla at me, man. Boss Up everything.
Yes, Lord.
In the building.
Man. Hey, I'm so excited to have y'all in the building, man.
For sure.
We're excited to be here, bro. Let's get it.
So, Rich, man, y'all been moving units for a minute in the city, man. How did this Bossing Up thing all come together?
Man, hey, like they say, man, it was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Salt, pepper, and every dip in a limousine. Nah, real talk, though, man, it was all a dream. You know what I'm saying? It was. We just stay focused on everything that we wanted to do, man. We trying to follow dreams, man. We ain't dream chasers because we living them dreams right now. You feel me? Yeah. We in and out the state, and we soon to be in and out the country with this Boss Up Music movement. You know what I'm saying? Denver, Colorado, Montbello, stand up. Hey, A-Town, all of that, man. You know what I'm saying? Park Hill, Eastside, let's go.
Let's go.
How long y'all been doing this thing, man?
Boss Up is now, well, we 3 years into, official label, you know what I'm saying, recognized by the state, the tax, everything, you know what I'm saying, everything is all the way 100.
We've been in the game for a minute, though.
We've been getting paid for a minute, man. I don't want to have to pull out no bins, but I will. I believe it.
Hey, so, like, how important is it to have that legit, tag to where people know who you are, you're official, your name is official, everything is professional? How important is that?
Man, it's highly important. You know what I'm saying? If you serious about your craft, and if you look at this on a long-term basis, you know what I'm saying? You want to have everything official, legal. You know what I'm saying? You want to have your stamp, your imprint on everything, man, because somebody could take your music and go do whatever with it, and you want to be able to defend yourself, you know what I'm saying? And me being the CEO, you know what I'm saying, along with my CFO, Megan Hampton, I call her Megan Boo, you know what I'm saying? She with the shenanigans. But we make sure everybody from the label is legal, you know what I'm saying, under ASCAP, BMI, whatever it is, you know what I'm saying? We make sure all they craft is legal, you know what I'm saying, as an artist and a writer. And just in case that day comes where something pop, you know what I'm saying, and somebody try to steal it, man, we out here to defend them, you know what I'm saying, and ourselves as well. So this is to be legit means a lot, you know what I'm saying? It's not just the image that we trying to portray, it's the person and what we all about individually, you know what I'm saying?
That's what's up, man. So, hey, Duce McGuire, bro. So, man, let the best know, man. You've been working in the city for a while now. You promoting, you doing engineering, you doing all kind of stuff, man. Give the fans, let us know what services do you offer, bro.
What's good? It's your boy, Duce McGuire. Yeah, everybody know what I do, man. You know, I mean, I'm kind of the person that's behind all the tracks, you know, behind all the music within the city. With a lot of upcoming artists that we got dropping a lot of good stuff and everything. So, I mean, my whole thing is just actually being in that producer's seat. You know, I do the artistry side as well, but I really kind of want to focus more on making sure the whole team and everybody else that I work with got that top-notch quality project.
So where you from, man, originally?
I'm originally from Nevada, man, but I've been living in Colorado most of my life, you know, so CO is the home.
That's what's up, man. So how hard is it to get out here and really get your name out here amongst all these other engineers and producers, man?
I mean, man, it's a daily task, man. I mean, it's like there ain't no such thing as sleep. You got to keep going. You got to keep pushing. I mean,
work.
You just got to keep working. That's what we do. You just got to really, really keep putting it in their face and networking with the right people. And
yes,
and
Lord.
Tap into them resources, man. That's what you got to do. And stay positive and humble.
Positive and humble, man.
That's
hey,
the key.
Hey, man, people, I think people stretch that word humble a little bit, man. What does it mean to be humble in today's rap game?
To be humble is to really just, for me, I mean, just kind of like just falling back, you know, falling back and allowing things to transpire and not just really partaking a lot of things that really don't have no significance in your life, you know, things is detrimental. So that's what it means to be humble to me.
So, I mean, I'm saying, bro, what if your song blow up and now you got all the fans, you got all the chickens popping, man? Is it still?
Oh, yeah, it's still there because she's...
That come with the territory, but you know what?
I got the wife in the building.
We got queens in the building right now.
No, but even if, though, you know, you still got to remain, you know, I just feel like, you know, you gotta stay humble, you know? You got to just continuously be who you are.
So do you feel like there's any particular artists in the industry today that are like... completely not humble and are kind of like just, is there any examples you can give us of what it means not to be humble?
I mean, there's an ample amount of, you know, of artists that I know that haven't really expressed their humility and things like that. I mean, there's so many in the name, man. Right, I could just, right. You know how that goes.
How you putting people out on blast.
Nah, you know, I mean, it's just from my experience.
Who's some of the people you've worked with, man?
Locally or nationally?
Period. Local, national.
Oh, hey, man, it's gonna take. Hey, that's a lot. That's a big question.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, I said like on a national standpoint. Let me see. The latest person I worked with was Mozzie. Who else I work with?
Shout out Mozzie. Let's
shout
get
out
it.
Mozzie. You know, Mozzie really doing his thing, though. I work with the Jack. I work with Cocaine.
The
I
Jackal.
Work with Badass, the Dog Pound, Selly Cell. A lot of old school cats, some new school cats, such as like Corey Guns. I work with,
man, I love Corey.
Yeah, I work with Corey Guns.
Don't forget your international.
Yeah, he's very much. Yeah, he's very much underrated. You know,
he's very lyrical.
Hey,
as well.
And I'm live right there.
So I've been with actually the on the artist, on the artist side, as far as being a recording artist. I've been doing it for some years. I would say since I was like age 13. But as far as like on the engineering side, about 8 years now consistently.
Man, this beat is just so fire.
It's smacking.
Boss Up just got the fire beat.
I almost start freestyling on this fucking beat.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, let's get the freestyle going up there.
Oh,
the
you don't
show.
Want that.
No, yeah, they're going to be some freestyling now.
You got that alpha male about to drop.
Alpha dragon face.
Let the fans know who you is, bro.
Man, it's Sean Peezz, Boss Up Everything. Y'all know how we rocking, man. A little bit about myself, man. I'm a hard worker. I've been working hard on this mixtape. A lot of people been sleeping on me, but this mixtape is going to wake a lot of people up on my craft and on how I've been working, how I've been moving. You feel me?
Hell yeah.
How important that people know you for your craft.
It's real important. That's a big part of the industry. You want people to connect with you and understand what you're talking about. You want people to understand where you came from. You know what I mean? I want people to relate to me. You know what I mean? I want a lot of people to relate to me. So if you've been through what I've been through, you gon' relate to me. You feel me?
Right.
Realness.
That's real.
So where you from, bro?
Man, I'm from Montbello, man. 55th and Auckland.
So what was it like growing up on 55th and Auckland in the early 2000s?
Man, it was like a jungle, you feel me? You never knew what you was going to run into, you know what I'm saying? You got Crips and Bloods, you got G's, you got Mexicans, you feel me? You never knew who you was going to run into, but it was like a jungle.
And the
like
white boys be with the shit.
Oh, yeah.
You know, pretty tight-knit neighborhood, man. How hard was it to avoid trouble?
Man, it was real hard. It was real hard, especially living with the police, you know what I mean? Because the police don't like us. You know what I'm saying? So they was steady harassing us. We never got a break in Montbello. So you know what I mean? We had to turn, like, on some real stuff. Like, music really saved me. Because if it wasn't for music, I'd probably be dead or in prison right now. You know what I'm saying?
That's real.
So I hear that a lot, that music saved lives. So how in what way has music saved you?
Man, if it wasn't for Boss Up, man, it saved me a lot. Man, I was out here gangbanging. You feel me? Like, I was out, I didn't have no morals or no goals until I start rapping. You know what I mean?
No.
Until people start putting that in me that I got greatness inside me. That's what Rich and Megan put inside me. So now I'm just going. I'm just going.
Yes.
I'm not going to stop neither. I'm
and
just keep
project
going.
And this project is dope.
Yeah.
What'd you used to have to tell Young Peezz when
I was hard-headed at first, man.
Let's think about that.
Yeah. Young Peezz. Yeah, I didn't talk to that guy. No, I'm Nah, man, you know what I'm saying? When I don't know, with me, I got to think about trying to recognize talent, you know what I'm saying? And I seen a true gift in that man, you know what I'm saying? And with the resources and the funds that was available to myself, you know what I'm saying? I thought, like, hey, you know what I mean? It's not just about me, you know what I'm saying? I know what we all done came from and what we all go through on a day-to-day basis, you know what I'm saying? So it was easy for me to get that man an opportunity and help him.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's not about me giving him the opportunity. He took the opportunity. You know what I'm saying? I just put a goal in his hand to try to reach. You know what I'm saying? And that man is reaching it right now. I couldn't be more happy with his album that's getting ready to be released.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
He's putting it down. You know what I'm saying? So he's surpassing every expectation that we didn't have for him. And we just going to take it to the moon. You know what I'm saying?
Ooh,
that's what it is, man. That man doing his thing.
I want to say one thing about this project, too. I got to say.
Go ahead and speak to the mic, dude.
I just want to say that I engineer for a lot of people and I do a lot of music. And not just because he's my teammate, but his project inspired me.
Man.
His project is really, it really inspired me. And it had me in the lab, like, whipping some stuff up.
Yeah.
So, you gotta stay tuned and stay focused for that alpha male too. Cause it's smacking for real.
Woo.
And I said it, I'm telling you.
Lord.
You got to put a little bit. Did you have a special place in your heart for Young Peezz when you were doing this work? Cause you guys are from the same camp.
Well, I mean,
they
like,
showed me tough love.
Yeah.
Straight. Well, I mean, with the team, I mean, we all got that chemistry. I got a great vibe with the whole team. I love them. We love each other. I love them infinitely. But Just listening to his first project, and hearing the growth in this one,
yeah,
that is what really inspired me.
Yeah,
and I told him, I told him personally, I said, hey, bro, your project is very inspiring. I came home and told my wife about it, too.
I got to say, man, you is pushing that thing, y'all. Peace.
Yeah,
appreciate that, man.
I see you online, you know what I'm saying? You got your little modeling game going. But then, you know what I'm saying? I look on YouTube for a song of yours, and you got it.
Yeah.
Got them bars. Let's get it.
Say that again.
When you start doing music?
Man, I've been doing music since I was about 14.
We gotta pop that thing.
My nephew's dad used to make me come home after school and freestyle with him and all his homeboys. And that no matter what, I'd stop, he'd just keep going. I've been doing it since I was 14, but really I just started recording maybe last year sometime. Maybe summertime last year.
So you know how to write a 16?
It just came. It came when I just kept gassing.
Hey, that's called raw talent.
I just keep on going. Raw I just keep talent, going. He, I told you, my brother said don't stop.
Yeah,
Aspen
is fire.
What about the modeling thing? What grabs your interest in modeling?
Oh, man. I've always loved modeling. First of all, I loved America's Next Top Model. I'm sure everybody did, you know. But I really just loved it. I loved the art in it. I could be who I want to be. I could change my wig, you know.
And you can do
absolutely. It looks like we got people calling y'all. They trying to talk to y'all.
All right, man, tell them to tap in.
Tap in, man.
Hit them lines, man. We in here right now. We in here with a lot of winners.
Making noise.
Man, you can have some.
Of course, man. This glass is y'all turned up with us, man. Right now, damn it, we're family.
You know, I definitely feel like there's an opportunity for me to grow. You know, and I don't mind working with any and everybody. You know,
one
thing I could say about female artists in Denver, they need to show each other more love. Because the females is against the females, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't really feel like Denver artists really show as much love as we should toward each other, but we need to start today. You know what I mean? Because I'm showing love for everybody, you know what I mean?
That's that
so.
Shit, people.
Yeah, it is that.
Red Fox Moonshine.
Yeah.
Would you agree with that, Rich?
I definitely agree.
What was the question?
You're born in way, so it's still funny.
Most definitely, you know what I'm saying? Female artists are winning right now. You know what I'm saying? If you ask me my opinion, you know what I'm saying? They winning right now, and it's well-deserved. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's well-deserved. But at the same time, give credit when it's due. You know what I'm saying? That's a problem with us right now out here in Denver, especially. Mm-hmm. We don't give each other enough credit. You know what I'm saying? So I just want to send a shout-out to all the ladies that's doing their thing. You know what I'm saying? Of course, Azpen off top. You know what I'm saying? Lady Boss Up, she in the building. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Cool Quay, man. I follow a lot of stuff that she
shout
does,
out
man. Shout-out Cool Quay. You know what I'm saying? And there's a lot more. But, yeah, they winning right now, man. They deserve that attention.
Hey, let me give somebody a shout out real quick. Shout out DJ Kunta, man. Shout out DJ Squirrel, man. I see you, man. You tapped in, man.
Yeah, shout out Squirrel.
Much love, man.
Hey, giving us a lot of love on our live feeds right now, man. And we going in. Let's go.
Shout out K-Tone.
You know what I'm saying? I'm right now on your Spotify, bro, and I definitely want to get to the end, man. Can you go ahead and tell us about that song?
Oh, wow. That's crazy. Yeah, I just released that song, man. The End?
The End, yeah, man. It's right here. It's one of your latest releases.
Yeah.
You definitely want to leak it today.
Yeah,
can you give us a little insight about the song?
Yeah, first and foremost, that track was produced by Tropics Beats. Tropic is a dope producer. Everybody rocks with Tropics. And it features a new upcoming female artist that I'm working with by the name of Elise. And she's actually a vocalist, but now she's into the rap. You know, she's
shout
into
out
the rap
Elise.
Lane.
Let's go.
Yeah, Elise, she'll be here. She'll be here the next time we pull up.
How important is it for you to have those feminine features on your music? And
very much. It keeps a balance, you know, and it lets, you know, because, I mean, we know as in the hip-hop world, you know, you can count, like, the female MCs on your hand. You can count them, you know. So it just keeps a balance, and it just adds more, you know, new fans to everything that I'm building and stuff like that. And also give her a chance to really get out there and get herself wet in the game.
Well, why don't you go ahead and introduce the song, The End, bro, to the fans.
Yeah, everybody check out this new and latest and greatest thing.
Let's go!
Turn up! Hey.
Let's go!
Featuring Helis. The End.
Let's go!
Man, what's Tropics. Up? Shout out to Tropics Beats.
Yes, Lord!
What's up?
And y'all tell me what y'all think.
They fucking with us, man.
shit. Somebody just keep loving our shit.
Yeah, they love us. That's what's up.
Shout out to... Gotta get bro in there.
Tap in on that, man. Yeah, we gonna take a champagne break. You know what I mean?
I'm reclusive a lot. On when they do the club. And baby beautiful.
How he get this before me, man?
Hey, my boy, I know.
Oh, nice. Oh, yeah.
I can't do it on camera.
Oh, snap.
We almost got sent out of
dude.
It's Kool-Aid, man. They got some good
stuff. And we got a lot of soda.
Sparkling soda. Oh, wholesome.
Yeah.
It's wholesome.
Right on, PJ.
Need water in here, man.
He said he tapped in with you, bro.
Mm-hmm. Yo, what up, bro? PJ, what's happening? In the building right now.
Hey man, y'all stay tuned. Me and Doja Man gonna do some shit, man.
Hey. Shout out to my boy Rage. Always.
Outrage, what's happening, bro?
Outrage in the building.
We see you, bro.
Rage. Shout out to the Boss Up Models too, Tanya and Ash.
Where my guys at, man? Where? Hey, what's his name? What's the big dude?
Wayne quick.
Who?
Wayne.
Shout out Wayne.
Shout out Wayne. Thanks for tuning in.
Big Q.
Hey, man. Boss Up fam.
Shout out Wayne. That's Wayne in the red shirt, y'all. Shout out to that guy and his team. You know what I'm saying? They doing some big things.
Tell them about your show. Tell them about your show.
The Death Fest. I tune in with them. Let them know. Let them know where to find you.
Production. Remember Death Fest. Look out for all the shows coming up.
Yes, sir. Ooh, there you have it.
The best life had to let it go.
Hold up, dog. Hey.
You stole my heart. Such a clap, though.
Hey.
All petrol. Told you my plan. You rocking with it. Kicking back, me and you, no soccer shit. I can't admit, there were times when I've been a jerk. And ain't no x-ray needed, I see you hurt. Ain't no comparison, you one in a meal, so Aaliyah. Get butterflies in my gut every time I see you. Made your mind from the jump, like in cables do. On that goofy shit, playing you. You make me wanna be a better person.
I got that nice battery saver on this thing.
My phone the super saver.
He said, what happened to your phone? I just recharged it that
way. That's crazy. I ain't never seen that happen.
He got that little app.
Aspen Winters IG.
Hey, he got a whole app.
App.
Yo, Megan need that app,
got
bro.
Got a whole bunch of stuff coming up.
That app, bro.
She be on her phone like, oh.
Her shit died, though. I am that chick.
Okay.
Let's see if we can get this one.
Dude, you got another chair? He can just slide in over here. You know what I mean?
I want the camera to make sure.
It looks like
getting
everybody.
Oh, yeah.
Except
it ain't really getting Megan, though.
It's not supposed to get me. You like, y'all. Okay.
We
need her on in here.
No. Oh, you got that fat one.
Oh, she was spitting right there. She was spitting right there. I think that's about to roll back around the bar real quick.
You ain't got no charger on?
In the car. I don't got the wall piece.
That was Duce McGuire.
Yada.
I'm about to get a chance.
That was slap.
It was real smooth.
Thank you.
That was that heat.
That was that heat, man. We want to get into some more of that heat. Before we get into that heat, hey, Duce. Just to give you the FYI, bro, it is
8:45. They need
slide. Mm-hmm. So, okay. Thank you, bro.
Well, hey, before you leaving or what?
Yeah, I'm about to take off.
Before you leave, look into that camera, man. Tell the fans who you are, where they can reach you, what you about. Give me your last little extra.
What's good? It's your boy Duce McGuire, representing Boss Up Entertainment. Boss Up Everything, man. Connect with me, man. Y'all pull up to the studio, man. Pull up to Dream Big Media, located on 6750 Stapleton Drive in Denver, Colorado, man. We got two studios in effect. I'm the engineer there along with Antonio Noriega. Shout out to Antonio, everybody.
Shout out to Antonio. Let's get it.
Hey.
Yep, and just pull up, man, and we'll get you straight, man. You know, I'll take care of you. You need that mix and master. You need all that sauce, whatever. I got you, man.
What JJ say? Hey, this boy is dynamite.
Let's go. Get at me on every social media site, man. Just type in Duce McGuire, and there I am. I'm on everything that is. Every social media platform, everything.
Yep.
And I appreciate the love. Shout out to Headklapp Radio.
Different Doja Man in the building.
Well, Duce, hey, man, shout us out in the song you about to go lace, bro. Before you leave, make sure you get my info so we can, we tapped in, but I would like you to have my personal number, bro.
Most definitely.
Hey, man, I thank you for coming to the show, man.
Thank you.
I could just see it, bro. Your aura is amazing, man.
Thank you.
Keep doing what you're doing. The city needs you, man. Boss Up needs you.
Head Straight up. You. Shout out to the whole city, everybody. I work with everybody from Park Hill, Eastside, Aurora, man. I love them all, man.
It's all love, baby. It's all love.
It's just a Denver, Colorado affair.
It's just a Denver thing.
I hope you was able to touch base with some of them promoters.
Almost definitely. Yeah, I'm about to connect right now. It's out the park, though. But I really appreciate this time, man, and thank you.
Hey, man, you're welcome. Hey, next time you
I was on
town,
camera, bro.
I'll let you go and get
I got you. I know you ain't touching my hair.
What's up, Rich?
That was smooth.
All right, y'all, I'm out of here. I got to go to
yo,
work.
Yo, yo. What up, what up?
Yo, yo, be cool.
Hey, man, you got
all right, bro.
You got a nice team, meeting bro. You.
Right on, man.
I love you, bro.
I love you, bro. Be safe, man.
That's that brother we love.
All right, bro. You already know it, bro. This is what we do.
Your family's
right,
beautiful, bro.
Hey,
I'm gonna try to set up some
time
for like
Sunday.
Let me
know.
So
I got this beat for you too. You gotta hop on too. All right.
What's up with the cipher?
I got Richie.
Matter of fact, come Sunday. You
yes, sir. Hey, man.
And then I
got you. Peezz.
Make sure you on camera.
I see you later.
Yeah, I'm right here. Yeah, let's get it. Make sure. Hey, I got a new album dropping too. You know what I'm saying? A new mixtape.
Talk about it.
It's called Mobb Ties. You know what I'm saying? Mobb Ties. New mixtape coming out right now. You know what I'm saying? July 17th, we dropping that thing like a bomb, you feel me? Number Heat, it's a bunch of collabos on that thing, man. I got Duce McGuire on that, one of my longtime favorites, you know what I'm saying? And one of my people that I always looked up to, Interstate Ike, is on that thing, you know what I mean? We got Yon Peezz on that thing, you feel me? I got MK Luch on that thing, you feel me?
Luch,
you know what I'm saying? Out. I got Jit on that thing, you
Free
know what
Jit.
I'm saying? Hey, real talk, man. YGAM. Y'all know, I might have not said money. It right, but y'all know what we're talking about, man.
Flawless Money, what's up?
Mobb Ties, man. This is what we do, you know what I'm saying? Boss up everything. We in building right now. We in the building right now. Free KK, man. Free KK, man. Yeah, just so y'all know, Crazy dealing with a couple of issues right now, you know what I'm saying? But you know that boy dropped a lot of fire. And we gonna keep dropping that fire.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Don't feel like he missing in action because we got a lot of heat. He recorded like Tupac did.
Oh God.
A million tracks.
And just to let y'all know, Denver Doja Man on Headklapp Radio will be appearing on the Boss Up Cypher. Y'all tell him about the Boss Up Cypher we got.
Oh man.
Oh my Lord.
Oh man. Oh man. Oh my God. Oh my God.
They just added Doja to it?
Oh man. I don't think y'all understanding what's about to happen with this
That's
with this cypher.
Stupid.
You know what I'm saying? This Boss Up Cypher talking
about
crazy.
Bars?
Crazy, you know what I'm saying? It's crazy. Yon Peezz on
I'm
that
already
thing.
Done with my merch. My shit already recorded.
Yes, Lord. You know what I'm saying? Yes, Lord. We all the way in that thing. You know what I'm saying? We got Yon Peezz on that, Hood Rich on that. You know what I'm saying? Now newly added. You know what I mean? Denver Doja Man on that thing. You know what I'm saying? We got Azpen on that thing. You know what I mean? She tearing it up for the ladies. Hey, man, if y'all don't tune into that, something wrong. Something wrong. You know what I'm saying? We really trying to bring the heat and to bring the noise for not only just our state. You know what I'm saying? For everybody, you know what I'm saying? In and out of town, you know what I mean? We doing a lot of shows too, so stay tuned on social media, man, because we tear it up with the shows and all of that, man. My City Lit Part 3 coming up. My City Lit Part 3 coming up real soon. You know what I mean? I got music on Spotify, on CD Baby, you know what I mean? On SoundCloud, Hub Rich. You know what I'm saying? Megan. She knows, you know what I mean? She be behind the scenes real tough.
Shout out to my CFO, man. We got the best CFO in the world, man.
Megan holds a lot of hats. You know what I'm saying? She holds a lot of hats.
She's like the mama.
She's the mom.
Yeah, real tough, man. She put us in our place when we need to be put in place and so on.
Don't nobody want to get in trouble.
And just so y'all know, everything is family owned. You know what I'm saying? Family owned, man. This is we run this thing literally from the gutter all the way up to where we at right now.
Started from the bottom, now we here.
You said you need what, bro?
Yeah. Started from the bottom, now the whole crew.
Oh, we got you.
I'm good.
Yeah, hop in here. Hop in here. Yeah, we definitely should have brought some merchandise, some Boss Up merchandise. Y'all know we got the clothing line out as well. You know what I'm saying? Boss Up Business and the Boss Up Main Line.
Hey, yeah, I got my own clothing line too.
Yeah, bro got a clothing line as well. You know what I'm saying? We're not just into music right now, man. We into real estate. We into vehicles. We into music. We property owners. You know what I'm saying? We clothing line owners. You know what I'm saying? And it's really taking off. So definitely, I owe the whole team here some VIP shit. I mean stuff. You know what I'm saying? Stuff. VIP stuff. You know what I mean?
We're a little lenient, man. It's summer semester up here.
All summer 18.
And shout out Metro, man. Shout out Metro.
Shout out Metro.
Boss Up Entertainment, man. Yeah. Who knew?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, Peezz, you said you got your own clothing line, bro. Why? My question is, why have a clothing line? Why have all these things? Why not just do music?
Ooh.
Hey, man, because, you know, like, I'm really into fashion. You feel me? Ever since I was a little boy, I've been into fashion. My dad owns this clothing store. Shout out to my pops. If y'all need some clothes, man, go down to Eddie's Closet.
Man, interesting story about that. I go to the store. Didn't know it was your dad. We just did Summer 17, like, a week prior.
And yes, Lord.
I went over there and your dad, you know what I'm saying, he hooked me up too, man. He got me dipped in like the all white and yellow polo with the all whites and shit. So.
Yeah, I don't think they know to, man.
Right.
Send a shout out to your dad's store.
Sounds
man.
About
shout
right.
out to Eddie's Closet, man, straight up. But
like a week later, I seen you online. I was like, that's his dad?
Yeah, that's pop.
They look just alike.
The Closet, man, if y'all ain't been to the Closet, where's that located, bro? Yeah.
Man, it's located on Colfax and Florence, man. It's called the Hope Center, man. Y'all can Google it.
The Hope Whatever. Center.
The Hope
is
Center.
Dope.
Yeah, it's the old African mall.
Hope Center is like a buy black kind of situation.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I was like, wow, they got the munchies in that joint.
They got a church in there too.
It's all
that's
of that.
Raised.
All of that.
Munchies in that joint?
No, munchies.
Raised, all munchies of that. Is all that of that. Station now.
Yeah. Man. So how important is it these days, y'all, to bank black and all that whole job?
It's very important right now. It's very important. As far as like black businesses, it's very important to me because I was raised in it. Like my dad always owned stuff. Like. Mm-hmm. He recently just gave me his carpet cleaning business. Like, he's keeping me involved in family business. So, it's family orientated, and I really love black businesses. Just businesses, period. You know what right. I mean?
So, let me get this straight. You got a carpet company.
Yeah, I got a carpet cleaning company.
Promote the carpet company.
Man, Eddie, his call, Bitten's Carpet Cleaning, man. Free estimates, man. If you need your carpet clean, just get at me, man. It's very professional, all that.
I want to drop it in the link. I'm going to drop it, man. So
hey, man, I'm going to need you to drop. Hey, like I said, you know, a few things, man.
We do,
we're doing a few things around her. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Bro, so, you know, we got a printing company as well. It's called Bellside Prints and Designs, man.
What?
Once again, Bellside Prints and Designs. So,
dude,
you know what I mean? We do heat transfer. You know what I'm saying? We do vinyl. Pants. You know what I mean? We can print pretty much anything that you bring to us. You know what I'm saying? So,
Spell it out.
If you need, I'm going to let Megan take over on that because she's the actual owner on that business.
It's Bellside, B as in boy, ELL. SIDE prints and designs.
Straight like that. You can find it on social media as well. Just tap that in and you're going to find a link right to us.
Prints and designs.
Yes, sir. And we got the best prices in town. And if you find somebody that got a low price and you think they could beat us,
we're going to beat them still.
We're going to beat them. We're going to beat that.
This is the better way.
With dope quality and fast turnaround rates. We're doing this, man.
We're going to make our shirts, man.
Hey, man. Right there.
No doubt.
You know what I'm saying? We can do that overnight. Overnight, man. We work hard.
I see y'all online pushing that Boss Up merch, man.
That's right.
Yeah.
Right here.
You know what?
You know,
we got some Boss Up gear in the building right now.
That,
you know what I'm saying?
I got up too, you know.
Oh, of course.
So Boss Up gear.
Of course. Bronco Ganger don't bang, bro.
What's your anticipation on the Broncos this season?
Oh, man.
I got high anticipation on the Broncos, but we all know how they set up stuff and always fail. You know what I'm saying?
You know, I'm a diehard Broncos.
I'm betting everything.
Fan.
I'm betting everything. I bet the house.
We just got Bradley Tubbs, bro. Do y'all know what that means?
Prototype?
Something like it. I think it is. But we gotta still see how he performed, though.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
It's going to be great.
So, you know, we've been losing. We've been a lot of soldiers been dying in the city, man. Rocka, they're doing a shout-out to
Rocka. Yeah, shout-out Rocka, man.
And Commerce City, you know what I'm saying?
Rest in peace to both the
Rest Rockers. In peace, Aaliyah.
Rocka. You know what I'm saying? And I know, you know, free Crazy K, man. It's a shame that Crazy K ain't in the building with us right now, man. But You know, we love having his energy in the building. And so, you know, we spoke up on it earlier today and how the system can kind of really take a talented man away from his goals. So,
yeah, can
know,
I
kind of harp in on that?
Yeah, can I take the front seat on this? Can I come in the first on the head?
Go ahead. Y'all
please harp in on how important it is to stay, keep your nose clean if you want to have your rap music go anywhere and have your rap career.
Hey, man, true story, man. Last year before my album dropped, I went to jail. You feel me? And it opened my eyes to a lot of stuff, and it matured me as an artist because I didn't tell nobody. You know what I mean? I just went to jail right before my album dropped. And people was like, what the hell? Where is he at? His album's supposed to drop. So at the end of the day, it's good to stay clean and stay out of trouble because you don't want nobody to be listening. You don't want to be in jail while your album dropped and you can't even see the type of stuff that's going on.
Gonna be like hustle and flow.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so it's good to keep your nose clean. You know what I mean? Stay out the way, man. If you really trying to do this music, do this music.
I want to challenge that because, you know, a lot of the music today encourages guys to get out here and tote pistols. You know, all that old John.
Get money for listen. Bitches.
Bang it off of a sack, you know. And
listen.
I feel like the music doesn't really speak on the pain beside of it, on the side of it. You know, a lot of us went out there thinking, oh, if I just sell dope, then I can become a rapper. And then we end up going to jail and setback after setback came. And I'm a living testament of that. So harping on how important it is. And Richie, I want you to chime in on that. How important is it to, you know, just following up on from what Yon P said of just keeping your nose clean, and how bad can it affect your career if you don't?
I mean, it can be detrimental to your career and to your goals. You know what I'm saying? I think the biggest problem is a lot of these artists can't weigh things out evenly. You know what I'm saying? You gotta be able to weigh out your personal life and all your struggles opposed to your music career and all your goals. You know what I'm saying? If you can't weigh it all out, then it's bound to collide in a bad way. You know what I'm saying? And unfortunately, that happens to a lot of dope artists. You know what I'm saying? From the town. You know what I mean? They let these influences of the streets and so on and so forth take over their ability to accomplish these goals. You know what I'm saying?
That's
so
real.
You have to find a balance. You have to find a balance in your life in order to be successful. You know what I'm saying?
And I want
to
chime in on that.
I'm still working on that myself. You know what I mean? But I'm trying to master that plan. You know what I mean? Because you can't be a leader if you're not leading the correct way. You feel me? You know what I mean? So I just try to the send out the right vibe and give the right feedback. Because like you said, Doja, like you said, man, a lot of these cats get influenced by the music, you know what I'm saying, and what a lot of these dudes be saying, and you gotta understand, a lot of these dudes don't even really actually live that type of life.
Right.
They just talking some stuff that they, you know what I'm saying, that sound good, you know what I'm saying, opposed to me, I don't live that life, you know what I'm saying, I'd have been shot multiple times, I'd have been stabbed multiple times, I'd have been in a burning house and been burnt up, I'd have been in prison multiple times, you know what I'm saying, and then I still managed to bounce back. That's also one of my new tracks, newly released, you know what I'm saying,
the bounce back, baby,
off the album,
right, it's called bounce back, but, you know what I'm saying, but it's real though, you know what I'm saying, and everything I speak in my music is real, you know what I'm saying, and anybody that knows me personally knows that this guy right here, he be spitting some real truth, some real facts, you know what I'm saying? So you can't get consumed in what people talking about, you know what I'm saying? You got to weigh out the difference. Is it real? Is it true? Is it possible? You know what I'm saying? So that's how I feel about that.
Absolutely. So
Aspen want to tap in on it.
And I actually want to tap in on that because, you know what, even the same with a lot of women, you know, a lot of women, they try to follow this dude. And follow everything he got going on, trying to be this writer. And they don't, you know, a lot of women, they lose their way when they trying to be a writer. They trying to do what this dude trying to do. They trying to hold guns like him. They want to wear his flag. That's not
speak
cool.
Speak on it.
That's not cool. You know what I mean? We still ladies speak at the end it. Of the day. Be a lady. When a dude is watching a music video, they don't want to be like, oh, now she's sexy. She got that red flag. Now that is something to see right there. No, that's cool and all, but in reality, that's really not cute. Like, what are you?
What's your advice to the young women out here that just stay in love with a man?
Don't be stupid over a man. You know, you could be in love as much as you want to be, but don't be stupid. Find your own way. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
It's cool. You don't have to be a writer. And if you be
you
a writer,
in.
Yeah, do what you believe in. If you a writer, be a writer and be a boss with it, though. Boss up with it, though. You know, if you're going to be a
like
writer,
that.
Look.
So do you feel like
Megan, does she have to get up in this to see what a real rider boss lady really is?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
Show your
like,
face one time so they know who she talking about. If you don't lean that, in here, if you don't lean up in here.
Hey, I'm going to chime in on that too.
Come on, sit on up in here, sugar.
It's a lot of people, it's a lot of artists in the city who rap about stuff they ain't never did or stuff they ain't never had. You feel me? Like everything that we rap about is real. If I say I'm toting a pistol, that's because I tote a pistol. Like I'm not doing this just because I seen YG or somebody else do it. You know what I mean? Like we grew up in this life. You know
don't
what I mean?
Be easily influenced.
Yeah,
man.
Like we grew up in this life. You know what I mean? Like this life.
Unfortunately.
You know what I mean? Like this, it's not on us. It's in us. It's not a t-shirt. You know what I mean? Like, that's what Ike say, man. It's not in me. I mean, it's not on me. It's in me. It's not a t-shirt. You know what I mean?
So that is
everything that we rap about is real. Like, it's real life. Everything is real life. Like, the struggle.
So like Nas say, you know, hip-hop is one's truth. And I feel like the truth is the tier. Obviously, you got a lot of these rappers come out, and the labels seem like they encourage them to be speaking up on the gangster stuff. And then, you know, now they're a security risk. When they go state to state and do their shows, it becomes a security risk because you rapped about this. Your fan base that you targeted was about this, but now you
I love that mask.
Me too, I gotta get him on my line.
You know, and I feel like, I don't trust in mainstream like the labels, man. I don't feel like what
me
they're
neither.
Doing, they're not appropriately representing.
No, they're not.
You know, certain artists and I feel
right.
like Kanye West.
These young kids. How do you feel about the Kanye West rant, man?
Man, it's fucking garbage. I'm sorry. That made me a little emotional.
Duck him, man. Duck him. He can kiss my ass.
I don't feel like that. I don't feel like that.
He can kiss my ass.
I'm not saying
I don't agree with a lot of stuff he says, but how he presents it is garbage, and the image that he's portraying and that he's giving the world is garbage too. He's portraying the image of an unstable human being. And what do we just talk about? People being influenced. So what do you think is going to happen? People going to follow that unstable personality.
He did that for publicity.
And fall off. But I mean, you could do it for publicity as well. You know what I'm saying? You could do it for publicity as well. Like when he got on stage and got to ranting about, you know what I mean, Beyonce album.
That's facts.
I mean, though. I mean, it's not him. Because if you look at way back, it hasn't. Before his mom died?
Yeah.
Was he this way?
I got something to say.
He was talking about Jesus. He was talking about Jesus before his mother died. So don't give me that.
Yeah.
But his music, bro, his music was way realer.
Man,
you know what I'm saying?
This man said
he's an industry guy now.
This man said slavery was a choice, man.
Dozerman, you agree with
get
that?
Out of here, man.
Hold on, Dozer. What? Hold on. Stop trying to run from the question. Stop trying to run from the question.
I'm speaking on this. Pull this
on
fire right now.
It was a choice.
Let me get some of this. That's wrong.
That's wrong.
Back then, fucking
choice. It wasn't a choice. It's a choice now. He's talking. But back then, that's just like saying my grandma grew up in slavery. She didn't want to be no slave. Okay. So he can't say it was a choice.
But it goes back to Nat Turner. I don't know if everybody's familiar with Nat Turner. You know what I'm saying? Black people was scared. We was, you know, that we were scared. We had a lot of fear put into
some
us.
Black people.
And most of the black people. You know what I'm saying? If they had government, the mayor, the people down the street, everybody was racist. Everybody was against the black people. Did the black people decide, hey, let's rise up together and really overcome this situation, try to do something? Everybody was scared. They had that same mind state. No one wanted to do that. So yes, slavery was a choice.
Lord, if I was a slave,
that's
disrespecting our culture back then.
Okay, I get it. This is the point that I want to be made, though. Kanye West is an artist.
He's smart.
He used to be a
One of the top five.
Artists are very misunderstood.
Very.
I think everybody can misunderstand something in some of you guys' music.
He's a Kardashian. You know what? Anybody that messes with a Kardashian always fails, damn it.
Look at Lamar Odom.
Come on, bro.
TMZ is built to make you look bad. Like, he just needed a different place to vent.
Man, this happened before TMZ.
Have you heard the song with T.I. chewed him? T.I. chewed him up every time. Man, that song, you need to play that. Play that song.
That is a good song. That's a voice of the... We can't lose Kanye West. We can't afford to lose
him. Yeah, we can.
That's a voice.
Yeah, we can. Duck him. Duck him.
He's done.
Listen, he's a stranger. I don't even know who that is.
His beats don't even sound the same anymore.
I listen to his old music.
I listen to the college dropout.
So that's called selling out. Hold on, bro. So what you just said, you said he did it for the record sales. Okay, but that's selling out. And I'm sorry, but I could never. And I would never. Nah, bro, you just said that. You said he did it for the record sales.
If you and Kanye West were having that conversation behind closed doors.
He gets slapped, first of all.
And I'm coming right behind him with the
uppercut.
I completely agree.
You know, that little 10-minute, 30-minute rant on TMZ was just a
all right,
bad.
Well, nah, bro. It's not just about TMC, though. It's not just about that. It's about the image that you're portraying. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, and this has been happening way before TMZ, bro. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I feel like we need to get out. We're giving him too much energy right now.
Somebody said
we giving Kanye too much energy right now. You know what I'm saying?
Well, get on that boss up energy.
So, what's boss up? What's the biggest thing that you guys are trying to push to the world right now? What's you guys' marketing?
I'm gonna pass the mic around on this one, you know what I'm saying? And I definitely want to get Megan in on this because she's the CFO and she knows about a lot of upcoming projects and things that we want to release to the community. And also, I just want to put out there, we have been in heavy negotiations with Universal Records, Bungalow, and all of that, you know what I'm saying? But the things got to come the right way, you know what I'm saying? There, you can't give up what you've been working so hard for and what you put your heart into for just anything, you know what I'm saying? So I speak on anything and everything, you know what I'm saying? I don't muffle myself and I don't have a filter, but our biggest projects as of right now, you know what I'm saying, is doing this huge tour right now. I think it's 18 or 20 states, or okay, you know what I mean, I might be mispronouncing it, but we gonna hit 20 different cities, you know what I'm saying, and just put the brand on the map, you know what I'm saying, it not just for Denver but just for us individually, for our crafts, you know what I'm saying. I believe in everybody individually, and also I kind of want to throw this in, this might be a little off topic, but speaking of people just building on their, you know what I'm saying, on their crafting and their everything, is Denver Doja Man. You know what I'm saying? I came a long way with this man but when we had this stuff that we doing right now was just a dream. It was all a dream. You know what I'm saying? When it was all a dream, you know what I'm saying? And we really putting our feet to the pavement, you know what I'm saying? And we really making things happen. And shout out to all the connections that we have gained along the way and the people that believe in us. You know what I'm saying? That's what it's about. So we got a several different clothing lines right now. You know what I'm saying? We have the Boss Up brand. You know what I mean? We have the Boss Up printing company. Well, excuse me. It's like a sister company off of Boss Up. You know what I'm saying? It's Bellside Prints and Designs. We got that popping. We got our models from the team. You know what I'm saying? A couple of models. You know what I'm saying? Ashley. You know what I'm saying? We got Azpen. You know what I mean? We got comedy. People from the team now, you know what I'm saying? So it's just not just about hip hop to us, it's about rock music, it's about hip hop love and soul and all of that, you know what I'm saying? Hey man, and we getting ready to drop a DVD, and we getting ready to we getting ready to sign a deal with YouTube to do a live show on their whole little network, you know what I'm saying? So reality show, you know what I'm saying? So it's all in motion.
Culture that,
yes we do, yes,
assumes a lot of confidence.
Speak on it.
What's the whole, what does it mean to be mob? Montbello Mobb. Because guys aren't the first time I've heard it.
That's deep.
Everybody's mobbing is, like, everybody has different, like, meanings of mobbing. You feel me? Like, it can mean money over, you know, it can mean
it can mean a lot of stuff. Like with my mobbing is like, we Montbello, we from Montbello, so we all mob together. You know what I mean? We all is one. You know what I mean? Especially the people that I grew up with. You know what I'm saying? Like everybody else's mobbing can mean different. Mobbing can mean different to anybody. You know what I mean? But our mobbing is different.
Well, I mean, can I jump in there? The true meaning, because this is I'm happy you brought that up. You know what I'm saying? The true meaning, the original meaning. You know what I'm saying? Because people done took that mm-hmm. and twisted it in their own ways. And me personally, you know what I'm saying? I don't like it. You know what I'm saying? But it's what happens when you have something that's trending. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That that people will jump into it. It started from Montbello. You know what I'm saying? It started from Montbello. It was handed down to CAC, Interstate Ike, all of those type of people. MNLD. You know what I'm saying? They actually introduced the whole black mob family to Denver, and it originated in Montbello for Denver. You know what I'm saying? And really, it just means unity. You know what I'm saying? We unified and we built to build each other. You know what I'm saying? In any and every circumstance, we are meant to build each other. You know what I'm saying? And help each other reach the next level. So when you hear everybody talking about mob and they putting their own little twist on it, money over this and all of this nonsense, that's nonsense. I'm an original mob member. You know what I'm saying? And I'm here to tell you the origin of the mob is about family. It's family oriented. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't mean any kind of gang nonsense or any of that. You know what I'm saying? It means power amongst our people. You know what I'm saying? And trying to build one another and really taking it to it's similar to a mob scene, because we can get filthy, you know what I'm saying, over what we believe in, but you know, it's all about love. You know what I'm saying? That's positivity. That's what it's originally about. You know what I'm saying?
So Azpen, how'd you end up a part of my Boss Up Entertainment?
Well, Rich, I've been knowing him since I was a little girl. Like, I was in elementary, running behind him and my Bello, trying to go to Falcon Park and see what they
putting
doing.
Putting sand in little kids' like, pockets is, you know, and all of that
trying
nonsense.
To, you know, and when I got older, my bro, you know, he reached out to me. You know, he seen me doing my thing, seeing that I was really trying to do something with myself, you know. And he reached out to me and, you know, we kind of went from there, you know.
That's what's up, man. I always like to know how people met, because it's, you know, you never know, man. The strangest things bring us together.
Yannick's my kid's uncle.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's what's up. So yeah, it's like real family right here.
Like real family.
I just
like,
told him that mom didn't know, but that's what we're about. Like, it's like, family,
I know his mom. I mean, I know his whole family. He know my mom. He know my daddy. Like, it's all in the family. Like, we real life family. Like, it's not like he don't know my grandma. Like, he knows my grandma. He knows my dad. Yeah. He knows my kids. Well, you know what I'm saying?
And I don't mean to cut you off, bro, but you know what I'm saying? Boss Up ain't just a collage of people that's been knowing each other forever. You know what I'm saying? I've ran into myself and Megan as well. You know what I'm saying? Have ran into people that we believe in that we've never met, but we follow everything. Everything that's going on in the city, especially these men behind us. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if our live feed can really see everybody behind us, but we follow that too. You know what I mean? Their craft, their version of music, we follow that as well. So, you know what I'm saying? We sign people from different backgrounds. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, I believe in the Lord. And God loves everybody. You know what I'm saying? So I'm somebody that loves everybody, and I can find a love for anything in this world. You know what I'm saying? So it just it's crazy how things come together. You know what I'm saying? And even the artists from Boss Up, I'm an artist as well, so we don't take those labels like CFO and CEO like we up here above anybody. You know what I'm saying? We all on the same platform and we trying to make it up here. You know what I'm saying? And we trying to bring anybody that we meet along with us. So even our artists and everybody, the models, everybody, they brung people to us and we looked at them with them and said, you know what, let's give that person an opportunity, a chance. And we put our energy, our power, our money, our resources, our, you know what I'm saying, our sponsors, everything behind that person. If it don't work out, then you ain't meant for this. But I kind of want you to get our ring on this. You know what I'm saying?
So you're the CFO of Boss Up?
That's right.
Okay. So what's the CFO of Boss Up? What's your job?
I manage the money and I keep everybody in track.
I gotta make sure they all behave.
She wear a lot of hats,
so,
man.
So, yeah.
A lot more than that.
Yeah.
That's the mama
boss. I do a lot of stuff.
Setting up shows. I'm talking about making sure everybody gets paid, because that's an important thing. You know what I'm saying? When we do work with anybody outside the label or anybody within the label, and it's a job that pays money or so on or whatnot, you know what I'm saying? They got to, that paper got to get paid first, because we're not in the business of burning bridges. You know what I'm saying? That's why.
There you go.
Hey, drop it in there.
But yeah, there's a lot that I do. And you know what? I was kind of new to the music industry experience until I started dating Rich, and we decided to, you know, create this company. And there's a lot that he's taught me, you know, over the years, and there's a lot that I've known just from my background. So it was kind of a good thing that, you know, merge together, and just like the business aspect and, you know, how to talk to people. That's also been something that I've liked to do on the team, is helping others, you know, on the team, like be more professional.
Image protection, all of that.
Exactly.
Yes.
It's important to have that. It's important to have that.
I didn't got in trouble.
Management
too.
Kind of that structure. And, you know, you got to definitely have all your ducks lined up. And, you know, I can understand how important it is, because I'm right now in the need of a street team myself. You know, we got a lot going on in the city, and I can't be everywhere at once. So it's always good to have somebody who can
help the structure. Man, I
got to
get that guy.
Hey, tell us.
We got to get the cookie in, bro.
Give me another glass.
We about to turn it up even more, bro. Listen, bro. Hey, Doze, if it's cool with you, where's my guy, where's Mackie at?
He's right here.
Hey, there he is.
Mackie. Shout out to Mackie.
Hey, he act like we don't know who he is.
I'm following him. You don't even know who I'm following. I'm following right now.
I got to get my guy in his mask up here, man, because...
This guy.
You know what I'm saying?
We got to put him on one of our shows, man.
I need him right up here.
I don't know what y'all are talking about.
That's the pumpkin head.
I'm sorry. You know what? That's really his face, y'all. If y'all watching this live feed, that guy is really in the business right now. You know what I'm saying? Boss up in the building. We here to turn it up.
I'm just here and be drunk. That's all I'm saying.
Hey!
Pumpkinhead.
The turn up is real.
I'm sorry. What was that?
What'd you say? You said, yes, what you
said? I said, I know you had some in that flask.
Oh, yeah, we did, but...
He said we did.
Low key.
It's down now.
I'm going to need some
collaborations in the future.
I would love to do live shows.
Nice.
I would love to do that. You know what I'm saying? My guy right here. You know what I'm saying?
With rock
this,
band.
This man right
That's
here.
What I'm
yes.
You, dude, I would play do fuck ass guitar now.
I would love to do something with a rock band. And I would love to sit down with whoever is a guitarist. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if I'm saying that right. Whoever has the craft of knowing the guitar, I would love to sit down with somebody like that, man, because that live music. Right, that live music is the heart and soul of what we do. Everything gets switched to this digital nonsense and all of that. But, you know, it's rare that you hear somebody performing behind a live band and so on and so forth. So, I would love to get in the business with these guys, man, and do something. So, and this is on live right now. So, you know, we got to do it. Even if they try to back out, they can't do that. We in here right now.
That's what's up, man. I like to be able to bring you guys together with these guys so we can network
straight
a little
up. I'm with it. I'm with it.
I just feel like the city.
I even had to come in here.
The city to come together, you know what I'm saying, to help each other's music careers out. I think it's a community effort, man. I don't think being an independent artist is independent at all, man. It's a community effort. And I'm glad that you guys recognize that, and I hope that we can spread the community spirit within it throughout the city so we can get more people working together. Because that's what it's all about.
Yeah.
Not just rappers working
unity.
Together.
Hey, you know what? You said something that I almost slipped my mind, man. I'm going to let Megan speak on that, but we heavily involved in the community, and we do an annual thing every year. You know what I'm saying? For the community
really
and for the kids, and to raise money for their school, their education, all the stuff that they... their school supplies right and everything, man. So I'm gonna let you speak on that a little bit if you want to.
So that's we do an annual water ball bash. Usually it's out in Montbello. We're open to different locations, but that's where we primarily have it. And we just have a lot of different activities. We have live music. We have just a bunch of people from the community. We've had bounce houses, you know, barbecues, people coming out and doing raffles so kids can win school supplies, you know, just getting a lot of stuff donated so we can help out the community, because we are very big on community involvement.
Yeah, definitely. We love the children, man. We love the children, and like you said earlier, man, you know, we don't want to, a lot of our music has, you know what I'm saying, a lot of racy, you know, comments and things in it, you know what I'm saying, but at the same time, you got to know the person behind the music as well, you know what I'm saying. I'm heavily involved in not just my community that I grew up in, but other communities as well, and I love to help children out, and I want to help guide them, you know what I'm saying? I try to use my platform for more things than just myself, you
right.
know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
We are that's the type we think,
that's the type of things we on, man.
We're children's biggest influence.
What you say, Azpen?
We are children's biggest influence.
Elaborate on that.
All they see is us. Like, you know, if any, I don't know if y'all got children in here, even if you don't, a dog, right? You know,
I got
but
four. I got
one
five.
Thing, you know, that's I have two kids.
Big you.
You got five.
I'm winning right now.
You
know,
hey,
I know what I do.
I know what I do. Clearly, you do it well. You know what I'm saying?
You take your vitamins.
I might need some pointers in this, all that.
You take your vitamins. Nah, but you know, it's just, you gotta really think about
it. You know what I'm
saying?
Give me some pointers. I think it's. Hey, Azpen.
She said you took your vitamins.
Hey, real. Hey, I took a lot of vitamins, so that thing is like.
Yeah.
But anyway, you know what I'm saying? All right.
TMI.
Kids look up to us, you know. So you gotta watch the image that you put out into the world, especially with hip hop. You know, because
I mean, we say that, right? We say that all day long, but yeah. It's not happening. Like,
but you know what? It starts with you. If you go on every day, like, oh, tomorrow I'm gonna start something new, and then tomorrow you think about starting it, it's never gonna happen. You really have to make it happen. You really have to.
It's hard to break the pattern.
You know, it's hard to break the pattern. You know what I mean? But you really have to do that every day. You know what I mean? I make sure my daughter comes home. Come home. Hug your brother. Hug your daddy. Now you finna go read a book. You know what I mean? I want to teach them different. When I was coming home, I was going to go smoke some weed. So I don't want my kids doing the same thing. You know what I mean? Like, you really have to watch what you do around your kids.
That's a great example,
like,
man.
Seriously.
So what about the music? I mean, the content on the music, right? It's not necessarily kid friendly. So how do we?
Well, it's not. Can I touch on that? The content of the music is not necessarily for the children, but you know what? We can't control what people get their hands on. You know what I'm saying? Like my grandmother, I was raised by my grandmother and my great grandmother, but they tried to shield me and shelter me from a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But I still found my way to it. You know what I'm saying? So
make you almost more curious.
Yeah,
it kind of did make me more curious, because you know what I mean? They were sheltering me from it, so it's like, what is that?
Yeah,
exactly. That must be something important. But at the same time, you know what I'm saying, I still took a valuable, valuable lesson from the teachings that they gave me. You know what I'm saying? And that's the reason why I have the qualities that I got now as a man. You know what I'm saying? So even though I do what I choose to do, I still hold those qualities, and I'm still in implementing those things into my community, into my surrounding, into my music, into all of that. You know what I'm saying? We getting ready, and I'm gonna need Doja Man on this, and I'm gonna need everybody in this room. I'm announcing it right now. You know what I'm saying? That I'm doing a video and a song that motivates our community, and that's gonna contain our children. You know what I'm saying? And everybody
people.
In that, the people. You know what I'm saying? So I want to come to all of y'all sections. You know what I'm saying? And see a view of your life. You know what I'm saying? An example of your life. And we just going to go around to everybody's community. You know what I'm saying? And the song is going to be motivating, uplifting, empowering, and so on and so forth. Because this music isn't just about shoot 'em up, bang, bang.
No.
You know what I'm saying? It's not a drink this, drink that, hit this, hit that. Y'all know what I mean by hit this, hit that. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, there's more to people.
I need to
come on,
something.
Man. Don't leave.
We need you right now.
Don't
I got it right here. Let's go.
He's smoking.
White people disagree.
I
Hey, we is in Denver. I might have made a mistake on that. You know what I'm saying?
That's smoke weed.
I wasn't talking about the blow, you know what I'm saying? The blow, good, you know what I mean? I'm talking about hitting that box.
Keep it in Aspen.
All the grown folks know what I mean. All the grown folks know what I mean when I say hit that box.
Keep it in Aspen. Keep the snow in Aspen.
I know that's right.
So Aspen, how you doing? You know what I'm saying? You signed up to be in a jungle full of men, you know.
Oh, my God.
It's assumed to be that rap music is male-dominated. Imagine as a female artist, how are you figuring out how to navigate in that without portraying? Because, you know, you got rappers who, women rappers who portray themselves as being like the Trinas. And then you got them that, like the rap song, you got them more conscious. So where do you put yourself in that whole flow?
I'm conscious. You know, I'm always conscious. You know what I mean? But I'm just more real about what I do. I can't speak on what other female rappers do. I'm just real about what I do and what I've been through, you know, as a female rapper. You know, I've always compared myself. You know, I don't even want to say compared, but I've always looked up to Eve. Because Eve is not like any other woman. She's not. She's cute. She's sexy.
She's a woman.
But she's still a woman. But she still rides. She's a rough rider. And I can say I'm a rough rider too. I ride rough too.
True that.
And I was always like a little, you know, a tomboy, you know, but I'm sexy. I love my hair done. Oh, I love my hair.
And I love how she referenced somebody that was from the old age of music, I would say, and not somebody that's from this new age.
Hey, man, my
that
favorite female artist,
that
and people
real.
Might not like it, is Shauna from DTP. Yeah, bro, she was just so hood. She was just so hood, and she didn't sugarcoat nothing, bro. Like, I loved her style. She was more of that West, that Midwest style, like that Twista, you know what I mean? Like, she didn't stop gassing, you feel me? That's why I respect her a lot, bro. Like, that's one of my female favorites.
The sound wave is making its way to the Mile High finally.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it really is. I've heard a few female artists, Mo Love and Landy V, T-May, you know, I've heard a few female artists, Rula,
Trayel goes, Trayel goes.
And I grew up with Trayel, you know what I'm saying? We went to Marachek together.
Shout out
you know?
To the women that's doing it.
Just shout out to them because, hey, if you don't have a strong support system behind you, it's kind of hard. And one thing about... You ladies gotta have one thing. Ladies have a strong support system behind you. Because anytime when you're a female artist and you got your crew behind you, it boosts you up even more. Because you know what? One thing about being a female rapper, you know, it is kind of hard because every dude is trying to get at you. That's all it's always about. You see, hey, you want to come do a track, you get there, but you got drinks and liquor there for me. Why? You know what I mean? Like, I'm strictly business, and Aspen Winters is strictly business. I just want everybody to know I'm a good person. I love to work with you, but the music is the magic.
Tell them about your brand. What you building?
Well, basically, right now, what I'm building right now, you know, I have so much going on. Like, this music right now, as far as my music goes, I'm doing so well with my music. I Am That Chick just came out. I actually did a song.
Got a mixtape coming out.
We got a, me and Outrage got a mixtape coming out. We do.
Shout out Outrage, man.
It's called Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve.
Outrage G's, right?
Yep. Outrage G's. Yes.
I need to meet
Unfortunately, he wasn't able to be here tonight, but...
We're going to get him
in. He'll be in here on the next one.
He
This ain't y'all's last turner about. You know, this is us interest to...
When the album drop, I'm most definitely coming back.
Well, so I got a question for you, Young Peezz. And then after that, we're going to play a song by Hood Rich.
Is Gangbang overrated?
And this is a question that for the young years.
It's not overrated. It's not overrated because it's never gonna go nowhere. You feel me?
Is it against the government?
It's never
against the government. It ain't overrated.
I would have to say, yeah.
There you go.
Hey, gangbanging ain't overrated. It's just, it's never gonna go nowhere. You feel me? It's never gonna go nowhere. It just depends on how you carry yourself. You know what I'm saying? Like, every gang member ain't no bad person. No. I graduated from high school.
But then you got fake gang members.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm sorry, but Lil Wayne, all of them type of people, they ain't no real gang members, and they influencing the world on something that the world don't
the
know.
Thing.
You know what I'm saying?
Shoot them in broad daylight.
I'm out of that. I'm gonna let y'all Peezz handle that.
That's what they well, shoot them in broad daylight.
As far as gang banging, to me,
this ain't gang banging.
It's a lifestyle. It's
this
not,
is not gang banging nowadays.
Everybody it's just not. Think gang banging is about ripping the flag and seeing blood. Nah, man. We start gang banging to protect our neighborhood. You feel me? I didn't gang banging just because I seen it on TV. You know what I mean? Like, we was protecting our neighborhood from the police. Everybody was talking about from back then, like when we was gang banging, like everybody was like, oh, we just gonna gang bang just to gang bang. Nah, homie. That's why we get along with the Crips and Montbello. You can't name no other set that's from Colorado that get along with Crips that really mess with the Crips. You feel me? Montbello is a different section, you know what I mean? We different, you know what I mean? As far as gangbanging to me, it's a culture to me. It's like, gangbanging to me is like, all right, when I was gangbanging, my big homies taught me that, like, hey, man, you a man before anything. Go to school, graduate, take care of your kids. You know what I mean? Like, these young dudes, they don't even understand what blood and Crip means. You can't even tell, hey, man, what's the definition of Crip? Oh, nigga, I'm just Crippin', cuz. I'm just a Crip. They don't even know the meaning of it or how it started.
And a result of that,
you know what I'm saying?
There's been a lot of deaths and a lot of people going to prison and a lot of people dealing with hardships, you know what I'm saying, putting their families through a lot of nonsense because they trying to follow behind what a lot of these fake gang member rappers say and do. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of the and a lot of the real gang members as well in their communities, you know what I'm saying, teach them the wrong stuff. You know what I'm saying? So you know, gang banging isn't a thing of just, it's a fad now. Let me put it like that.
Right.
Gang banging is a fad now. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't hold the same values and the same meanings as it used to.
See, when we was growing up, we wasn't shooting people. We'd meet up at Falcon Park and catch the heads. And then afterwards,
oh, you would fight first.
And afterwards, we'd go drink or something.
You catch these hands.
See, but it is.
Like straight up.
Because
yeah,
now that means
if you're mad, we'll fight
a lot of and black women that, to have to be the leaders of their family.
Now,
because that puts us in a position to have to be the man. Because you guys, gangbanging takes our men away from us. You know what I'm saying? It's not presented right.
Unfortunately.
So that leaves us, the woman, to be the head of the household, and then we get this reputation of, oh, you're angry, you're bitter. You damn right. We had to do your job because you wanted to go out and bang this color instead of bang your child or bang this rent. Or do something like that. You know what I mean? That's
Lord
what you
Lord.
Wanted instead. You
that's, real, that's some real
so
talk,
it,
though.
It is, you know what I mean? So now we got to be in this position where we got to lead the family. And then we got to be, oh, if you ain't giving up the, you know, then you a B, you a hoe. Then it's this and that. You can't even be a black woman and hold your house down without you being bitter,
and
without you being mad.
That's true.
But I am bitter and mad. You know what I mean? Like,
and as far as to me, like, people don't even understand the meaning of it. Like, Bloods, it stands for brothers leading our own destiny. You feel me? Crips stands for community resistant in progress, my nigga. Like, all it is like, it's like they was going against the police. You know what I mean? It wasn't, back then, it wasn't people just walking around here saying they gonna kill this person. Nah, man, they was protecting their neighborhoods from the police. You know what I mean? These young dudes is just shooting people for nothing. And the OGs need to start teaching these young cats what they really need to be out here
don't
doing.
Don't nobody want to listen
but
to
you know
OGs.
What?
So what qualifies you to be an OG now?
An OG to me is just leading by example. You know what I mean? Like, if you say you're going to be positive, be positive. Don't say you're going to be positive and they see you next week on the block with a 40-ounce talking about you're going to shoot somebody.
But check this out. An OG, I'm sorry to interrupt, bro. But an OG doesn't necessarily, see, that's another misunderstanding of the meaning. You know what I'm saying? An OG originally doesn't just mean you're a gang member and
right.
He rolls in ranks. No, that a OG could be a banker that had 5 children and he guided all his children the right way. You know what I'm saying? Or he went through all kind of trials and tribulations through his life and he rose above the problems and all the negativity and he became somebody. That is an OG, somebody that is successful with their life, somebody that motivates others, somebody that opens the door for people, somebody that guides the innocent, you know what I'm saying, down the right path. That is an OG, somebody that survived through it all.
Bro, so look, you got this dope track on YouTube right now, official video, Bounce Back, man. We want to get into
Bounce Back!
Hey!
Yeah, they say Rich fell off. I tell them, where at?
Yeah.
You ain't never been a real Brita if you ain't
taking a loss and bounce back.
Hey, let's go.
So go ahead and give us a little spiel about what went into making this song. I see you got the video.
Yeah,
with the
film off,
I see you guys do a lot of acting in your videos, man.
Concept. Yeah, I think that acting is for me anyway, the acting is there's a lot of truth to the acting parts of my videos and so on and so forth, man, because it's just like stuff that actually happened, you know what I'm saying? So when you watch one of my videos and you see, like, you know, the skits and the acting parts of the videos, man, this is stuff that actually happened, you know what I'm saying? And I'm just living it out through my music, you know what I mean?
Straight up.
Well, without further ado, it's Hill Rich. Bounce back.
Dogs and shit, man. Hey, doggy. You ain't tripping or nothing, right? All right, man. This nigga got pit bulls and shit. I don't know whose fucking dog you is, but I just want some weed. I just want some weed, dog. You know? Pit bulls running around outside and shit. The fuck going on? Time is through with time.
Y'all listening to Bob Marley and shit? How you doing, Miles? Cool, cross it down. Man, you still mad about the door shit? I didn't hear you.
Okay.
What's up, bro? Bro! Hey, nigga! You good, bro?
I forgot you was coming.
I'm about to call the people for your ass to pick you up. You need attention.
Yeah, my bad.
Yeah, is that your dog though, man?
Hey,
this is a sneaky one. Yeah, nigga, there's leash laws, bro. So that motherfucker's gonna bite me. I ain't even tripping about it. Bro, this nigga's been saying I fell off. You know what I'm saying? I just need something to bounce back, bro. You know what I'm saying? What you got for me?
Definitely.
Oh my god. Yeah, that's that shit that's called death. Yeah, right? That shit is crisp. You always gotta bring that shit up. That's my whole issue about you. Man, you always bringing some shit. Yeah, bro.
What?
Oh my god, bro, I'm saying it still works. The bank will still take it.
But it's crinkled.
Can I use that?
Yes.
Oh, it's crinkled? That's how you feel? It's crinkled and shit? Oh, who is it? Anyway, this is the shit y'all will be shit.
If you ain't took a loss and bounce back, you can't say you a real gritter. If you ain't took a loss and bounce back, pussy niggas say I fell off. Tell them pussy niggas I'm back. You ain't never been a real gritter. If you ain't took a loss and bounce back, if you ain't took a loss and bounce back, if you ain't took a loss and bounce back, you can't say you a real gritter. If you ain't took a loss and bounce back. Now they got me on some other shit. I took a loss and then I bounced back. I threw my bitch about 30 racks. I tell that hoe to go and count that. And we'll play house like a steakhouse. We'll leave them niggas out back. These niggas drinking toilet water. I swear to God they wearing pantyhose. I've been trapping out of Commerce City with a pretty bitch with pretty titties. She getting money, so she fucking with me.
She getting money, so she fucking with me.
I've been drinking on this Crown Royal. Oh my God, I'm feeling so loyal. I been rapping that truest gang. 5554, man. Bless gang, nigga, bless gang. Catch a fade, let your brains hang. I've been known to do this gang thing. No snitching, no checking in. Did some time and then I bounce back. Hit the streets like where my crown at. Hit the streets like where my crown at. Pussy niggas say I fell off. Tell them pussy niggas I'm back. You ain't never been a real gritter if you ain't took a loss and bounced back. If you ain't took a loss and bounced back. If you ain't took a loss and bounced back. You can't say you a real gritter if you ain't took a loss and bounced back. Pussy niggas say I fell off. Tell them pussy niggas I'm back. You ain't never been a real gritter if you ain't took a loss and bounced back. If you ain't took a loss and bounced back. If you ain't took a loss and bounced back. You can't say you a real gritter if you ain't took a loss and bounced back. Lyrically, I swear I'm insane. I been running all these numbers up. You only gritting when the summer's up. Just holler at me when your money's up. Your pocket's empty and you feeling lonely. All your homies out there acting phony. I'm sick of hearing all these fake raps. Speaking on shit you don't do. Talking about shit you don't got. And amigos need to get popped. Tiny Cat told me don't stop. These niggas need to hear the truth. From the street straight to the booth. Punch a homie out his bra strap. Go ahead, pick his panties up. And watch how a nigga bounce back. Pussy niggas say I fell off. Tell them pussy niggas I'm back. You ain't never been a real gritter if you ain't took a loss and bounced back. If you ain't took a loss and bounced back. If you ain't took a loss and bounced back. You can't say you a real gritter if you ain't took a loss and bounced back. Pussy niggas say I fell off. Tell them pussy niggas I'm back. You ain't never been a real gritter if you ain't took a loss and bounced back.
I used to hustle with the Black Mafia family. You know what I'm saying? The BMS. All of them, I was just... You went on a lot of that stuff earlier, but you know, Jeezy, all of them, you know what I'm saying? I was around a lot of those people when I was doing, you know, type of stuff that wasn't, you know, like rap positive. So, yeah, all of that.
Richie.
Yeah!
Rich from Boss Up Entertainment.
Yeah!
Right now with Boss Up Entertainment, it's Headklapp Radio. I'm your host, Denver's Doja Man. Hey, y'all, we running out of time.
Why?
Oh, man.
Why?
Hey,
man, play that scheme real quick.
Which one, please?
Play that scheme.
Play that Aspen.
Play that Aspen.
We got a lot of heat, man. And, hey, man, y'all just got to tune into our social media networks, man. I'm telling you, because we bringing a lot of heat, man. And definitely, I definitely want to work with a live band. That would be
straight up, man.
Awesome.
That would be tight.
Definitely trying to make me sit. Straight up.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. You know what I mean? And that guy back here in the red, man, we hey, during the break, check it out, man. During the break, man, I learned a lot from that man just that fast. You know what I'm saying? I absorb, you know what I mean? I'm like a sponge. I'm like a baby when it comes to knowledge. You know what I'm saying? You can learn from a baby. And, you know what I'm saying? I was just taught a lot. But, yeah, that man's background is very similar. You know what I'm saying? So we all come from different backyards. You know what I'm saying? But that don't mean it's
all got the same
we all kind of water the grass in the same way. You feel me? So... Definitely shout out to all the fellas in here, man. Hey, Mr. Mackey, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to that guy right there, man.
Yes, sir.
Hey, love that dude. You know what I mean? Love that dude.
Or we could be from the same area and grow up.
That's what's up. That's what's up. So, hey, Peezz, man, tell us a little bit. Give us more of a little bit in depth about what it took to go into your next project, man. What you're trying to get out of it.
Man, it took a lot of hard work. Like, at first, like, I took this music stuff, like, for granted. I wasn't taking it serious. Until they released me from the label, you feel me? And it really opened my eyes and made me work harder. You know what I mean? So my first album, it was just a lot of riff-raff. It wasn't really like no meaning really. You know what I mean? I was just recording just to do music. But now that I take it serious and I'm taking my craft serious, I got a story to tell. And I got a nice story to tell and I want the world to hear it. You feel me? So that's what this album is gonna bring. I got songs for the ladies. I got songs for people who's living in the struggle, you know what I mean? I even got songs for the kids, you know what I mean? Oh, yeah, and I got a clothing line, too, you know what I mean? I got a clothing line for the kids. I got a clothing line for the ladies.
Tell them what it's called, man.
Lavish Bosses. Lavish Bosses is for the men. Lavish Divas is for the ladies. I got the baby clothing line coming out called Young Lavish Bosses. And I got the clothing line for the little girls coming out called Young Lavish Divas, you know what I mean? So I'm just working on a lot of stuff, man. I got a lot of stuff that I'm working on. Alpha Male dropped June 14th, man. Volume 2.
Yes, sir. Go get that. Go get that. Go get that, man. And after you get that Alpha Male Volume 2,
hey, man,
make sure you go get that Mobb Ties by Hood Rich, man. It's a lot of dope, dope music and lyrical geniuses on that thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Let's go.
I got a lot of features on there, too, man. I got MK Lucci on that thing, man. I got Crazy K. I got Jay Reeves, man. I got Flawless Money. I got Stroke on that thing, man. I got Hood Rich on that thing. I got a lot of dope artists on there that really mess with me. You know what I mean? Like, that don't play favoritism, because it's a lot of favoritism in the city. You know what I mean? It's a lot of artists in the city who don't get no clout, like Crazy K. Crazy K will eat half of these people. Like, he'll eat half of these rappers. Straight up. And I feel like they feel like he was a threat, so they didn't really show him no love. They showed him love, you know what I mean? But he'll murder people. Like, his delivery, his bars is just on a different level.
But you know what? Hard work. Can't nobody ignore hard work. You know
Straight
what I'm saying?
Up.
When you out there with the visuals and the real lyrical, you know what I'm saying, music, and you collaborating with just an entourage.
I had asthma attacks working on
this. We in this thing. You know what I'm saying? You in there, so you ain't got no choice but to pay attention to Boss Up, because Boss Up is everywhere on y'all, from modeling to comedy to clothing lines to clothing companies to printing companies. You know what I'm talking about? Hey, we even dabbling in the stock market right now. Look, it's real. You know what I'm saying? From hey, man, we selling vehicles. Hey, if you need a nice low priced vehicle, you know what I'm saying, that's gonna get you from A to B, just hit up Rich and I got you, baby. Boss Up everything, let's get it. Different Dose Man in the building, Sick Mackie in the building. Y'all know what it is. Headklapp Radio, man. Thank you for having
Headklapp,
us
man.
In here right now.
Hey, yes, sir. Having a little bit of technical issues with the keyboard.
Yeah.
I'm trying to pull up more of y'all's music.
Oh,
right now.
No.
I mean, as long as we still on air, I mean, we can make it. I can rap all mine's acapulco.
Okay.
Acapulco. I can do it acapulco.
I'm acapulco.
You know what I'm saying?
You mean acapella?
Acapella, but I like to say it acapulco, though.
You want to start the freestyle session?
I could.
Here it goes right here.
I mean, I could start a session.
Oh, Lord.
You know what I'm saying?
He don't want these problems.
Yes, Lord. They don't want these problems, man. This is highly exclusive. You know what I'm saying? I only seen this done on the Breakfast Club. You know what I mean? But even they had a beat. Let's get it. You just tell me when to go. Because I open the doors like dominoes. Patty cake. Hey, there she goes. Now they talking about that dude need to spit some rolls. But I'm telling you, I'm in here with the Mackie dude. Y'all know who I'm talking about. He a clap-a-doo. Automatics in the back while I have to snap-a-doo. I used to sell packs, but now I'm with the in crew. I don't want to have to cuss on the team, but I'll tell you what a dude do. I got a scheme on the next way to get a lot of cash in my pocket. And all these dudes want to act like they smash, but guess what? I really got the queen on the team. It's a lot of those things, but you can't even dream what I seen. I'm telling them dudes exactly where I need to be. And I'm
hey, man, hey, man,
too much?
They're going to have to pay for support.
Did y'all see that? That just happened. That just happened.
Off the top. Yeah,
man, we do this.
Drop that beat, man. Let me.
We do this.
I'm about to drop the beat just a second.
Yeah. I just picked up Azpen on the squad, and I ain't talking about no snow, man. She'll smash all of y'all. Yes, love, we go hard. We gotta come and ball. I got my guy in the back, and he done taught all of y'all. So let me show you something real quick. It's Richie Rich on the... Ooh,
he said Richie Rich. He took it back to the
That's old school. That's
hey,
old school.
Took it back to the mid 2000s.
They ain't called me Richie Rich in about 2000.
If you don't know me by my nickname, you don't know me.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, Skeeter.
Right.
Yeah.
I was gonna go there, but
Skeeter, you know what I'm saying? And I caught a lot of heat for that name when they came out with that stupid show called Cousin Skeeter. I know y'all some of y'all remember that. Some of y'all old enough to remember Cousin Skeeter. Yeah, man. I went to school the next day and Lord knows I did not hear the end of it. You know what I'm saying?
South Park.
Yeah, South Park, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Now look, Skeeter. They ain't hurting nobody. Y'all remember that? Y'all see, y'all don't know. Y'all, we over here. Thank y'all over there.
Chicken,
we over
here. Thank my chicken, Pam Pam.
Wow, you sound just like that guy. That's crazy.
I love cheesy pan.
So Cartman. Now we got voice impressionists.
Cartman in the building.
Right.
Let's go.
Damn,
he's
breaking
stuff.
Nah, that just fell. It just turned the mic, and it looked like it came from up there.
Oh,
Lord.
Yeah.
That's too far. It's coming right here, bro.
But where the screw at?
Right here, bro.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
For some reason, I'm not getting no playback.
Ah, sad day, man.
They only had a skip.
That sucks.
For 2 hours.
That sucks.
Dang, that sucks.
We still in here, though, man.
It's your girl, Aspen.
It's easy to turn up the crowd, man. Aspen, talk to him real quick, man. Tell him again about what you're doing and how you're doing it and where you're doing it at.
What's up?
Let me get up over here. Yeah. It's your girl, Aspen. Again, you know, I'm better known as the coldest winner ever. You know, I'm going to be doing my thing, you know, from the 303, doing my thing. Y'all definitely are going to hear more songs. I'm in the studio. I'm working on it. And y'all definitely are going to see more pics from me. The pics been dropping. And please yes. believe I'm doing it for Boss Up. So, you know what I mean? If y'all...
Find yourself.
No, he wants to put it on, but he has to plug it into the aux.
Yeah.
Oh,
I got it. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, we in the building.
Yeah, I found it. It's just press play, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'll be on the cipher with Duce, Richie Rich, Yon Peezz, you know what I mean? We definitely going to be in here doing that thing.
And newly added, oh, that boy Denver Dozier, man. I got you. See, this backup, man. I got you. You know what I'm saying? This is what we do.
Man, if y'all ain't here, y'all ain't nowhere. Right
straight
now.
Like that. Straight like that.
Shout out to Rage and Crazy Kate, man. I know how we work.
Really? Yeah, man. Yeah, hey, man, look out for them Outrage projects coming. Soon, Crazy Lyrical, you know what I'm saying? Hey, and we getting ready to release some new Crazy K music from that volume 2. You know what I mean? So
baby.
Be ready for that.
Go ahead and introduce your song with Outrage G. It's called Bounce.
This is your girl, Azpen. Definitely, this is a club hit right here. It's going to get you bouncing. So definitely listen to it. Get your bodies moving from
all the way up.
Azpen, bounce.
Shake all the way up.
I got a song with him too. He wrote a song.
But I need Duce to mix that shit.
And you know it. Yeah, eat that shit.
Got the wrong key, got the X pills, less potty. We're missing, baby.
Yeah,
definitely.
I need to connect with you guys, though, bro.
So your boyfriend,
you
better pipe down,
cause
I'll shoot his ass in the lobby.
I'm
side, nigga,
bam,
first. I ain't never scared to
have
a body.
When's the best time to try to get in contact? Man, you can email me anytime, whatever, nigga. I'll get in contact.
Ooh, that's dude for this thing there.
Yeah, for sure. So, yeah, call me. If I don't answer,
I wish that my other song, I could have played my other song.
I work at Comcast's regular job. Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. to 2 p.m.
Yeah,
So, this one yours?
Yeah, it's hers.
Yeah.
Man, I had like 5 shots of whiskey during my interview. Then I come in here and had a couple of hits of that.
Are you feeling good right now, man?
Okay. Yeah.
I was just like,
I was trying to hit you. It's almost 10 o'clock, man.
Just
close the door.
Really? Lock the doors on.
Yeah, just lock doors.
That means.
Man, we've been here for a minute.
Close party, y'all.
Hey,
that's a dope ass track from Azpen Winters with Boss Up Entertainment, man. Moving through, hey, Peezz, man, we gotta play something with you. So, how about that again?
Yeah, play that again.
Say that again, bro.
Play that.
Yeah, play that. You can play that scheme. Or you can play that Changes Faces with me and Stroke. You got all of it. I sent you all of it.
Okay, I'm gonna go to the email right now.
There's a lot, man. There's a lot. Case, yeah. I mean, dang it.
Dang it.
There's a lot. It's about my third slip.
I'm going to keep it lit. I'm going to keep it lit.
Yeah.
And worry what I got to say about me. I'm going to keep it lit. I'm going to keep it lit.
Swear that show made bitch.
But y'all on my, sucking on my,
Yeah. They understand it, man. We got some heat right now, man. Straight up.
That song really turns up the party, man.
Like, it does.
We perform that club go crazy. White girls get to slide on the floor and shit.
Yes, man. Hey, can I say this? Drunk white women for everybody. I said that. That was cool.
Okay,
we're still on air, so it must be. We still on air. Yeah, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Gotta love a drunk white woman, man. You know what I mean?
Shit. It's okay. Even the white guys don't understand what the fuck you're saying. You know what I mean? Like, it's all good.
It's love, though, man. I'm serious, man.
And I'm just going to get my ass whipped for hitting on the sisters. That's
it. See, look. So we're like, that's
all right.
Boom.
That's all right.
Y'all don't know this. If y'all wasn't, see, it sucks that sisters a lot of people like, can't be here right now because we really turning up right now. What is sisters like? Oh, Lord.
All types of ice cream, especially vanilla bean.
There we go.
I need some white chocolate.
Okay then.
Some vanilla.
What did you call it?
Vanilla bean.
Vanilla bean.
That's way better than
vanilla
bean.
Vanilla
beans
way better than vanilla.
So let's elaborate on this.
Why
bro
finds
the track?
What does that mean exactly?
What does that mean exactly?
What does the bean part mean?
So you mean to tell me you gave her $5 and you turn around and give her $5 more? That sounds like a crackhead move to me.
I'm good. I almost knocked down my mic, y'all. Yes, Lord. So they lie.
I know your time. I went to school with you.
Headklapp.
Yes, sir. Headklapp be live over here.
You smoking that? You're a crackhead. You smoking that?
Damn. Hey, what y'all? I don't know where that just came from, y'all,
Mathis.
But...
Hey, that's Judge Mathis.
That was like...
I know y'all watch Judge Mathis, bro.
Yeah, we got that popping.
Play that popping with me and Flawless Money, man. Shout out to my nigga YGAM. Shout out to everybody, man. You already know how we rocking, man. YGAM, man. Shout out to Av Grimm, man.
Yes, sir. FL, shout out.
Shout out to FL.
Hey, shout out to Throvish Flicks. Shout out to Timeless Images. Shout out to Lindell Spirit.
Yes, sir.
Shout out to Kurt Williams. All of them was great photographers. I also have Daquan. Daquan, he was just coming out with Paradise Pictures. He had to go into the hospital with a brain tumor, but that's my boy. Shout out to all of y'all. Y'all have definitely, man, y'all, my image has been great.
Yeah.
That nigga know what it is.
Mm-hmm. Boss up.
I be chillin' with them killers, tell my haters come and get me. Mama told me keep it on me so a nigga never lackin'. I be really quarterbackin' every every time I'm in the spot. Niggas say they looking for me, tell them niggas knock it off. Every time you see a nigga, I be dipped up in the sauce. Pussy niggas didn't know it, they was fucking with a boss. My ties over here, make a hater disappear. I be shooting at the niggas, never shooting in the air. I'm a Bellside nigga, really got it out the mud. Domo told me eat them niggas, and I'm eating niggas up. Hey, we can get it. I'm a mob ass nigga, yeah, you niggas know it's happening, nigga. Hey, we can get it poppin', nigga. Hey, we can get it poppin', nigga. Yeah, hey, we can get it poppin', nigga. Yeah,
we can get it poppin', nigga.
Hey, we can get it poppin', nigga. Yeah, hey, we can get it poppin', nigga. Hey, we can get it poppin', nigga.
My niggas get it poppin', nigga. Hey, we can get it poppin', nigga.
Talk to him, Flawless.
Bet
this 40 on this 30, get it poppin', nigga.
I smell it in the funk, I get the poppin', nigga. We don't ask questions, we ain't no callin', nigga. We just put up all black and clap all in.
Yeah, we gotta pick up the kids and some more shit right now, man.
We got you.
Hey, thank y'all for having us on, man. We truly enjoyed it, bro. You know what I'm saying?
No action, that's a bad habit.
Hey,
I got money on my mind, money on the dress, money on the
left,
money all heavy. They gon' hate on it, but we don't listen to it. Why? I got money calling me, and I'm getting to it.
Front parking lot.
Front parking lot? Oh, I parked in the back.
Oh, did you?